Let us pray. Eternal King of Glory, we bless your name for this time, for this season, and for this hour. The hour you have ordained, a purified and profound hour, to release your counsel of old, to download your heartbeat to your people. Therefore, as I'm grateful as your vessel that you want to use at this time, I come to downgrade myself. Lord, and I upgrade you, Lord Father, the God of the heaven and earth in me, that I may be decreased for you to be increased in me. That, Lord, you will make my tongue like pen in the hand of the ready writer. Lord, that you equip me, Lord, from heaven. You will engulf me, Lord, by your spirit.
Amen.
Lord, to speak not of my own, but to speak, Lord, of your agenda and your purposes. That in your name, the Lord, may be glorified.
Amen.
Lord, as your word goes out, Lord, let your word go like a two-edged sword. Let it, Lord, even go to pierce the heart of your people. Let it launch deep into their life, Lord, and bring out, Lord, your treasure that has been hidden. Lord, for them to be used, Lord, for your own glory, that the name of the Lord may be glorified.
Amen.
Once again, I stand on the rock of ages, Lord, I've done a second sound. I lean on the cross, I sit deep. My service, I pull the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
I bring announcement and proclamation that every spirit contrary to the spirit of the Lord, the spirit of witchcraft, sorcerers, the spirit, Lord, even that, Lord, even engulf people and cause disruption. Lord, even the spirit of queen of the spirit, queen of heaven, the multiple prognosticators, the astrologers, their swarmers, wherever, Lord, you may be ganging and gathered together, Lord, to disrupt your people, to even wander the mind of your people, I challenge you and I rebuke you in the name of the Lord Jesus. I pray, God, that you come and take your position.
Amen.
Be the chairman, Lord, of this gathering.
Amen.
And Lord, let the gathering of these people be unto you. And let the name of the Lord be glorified.
Amen.
Thank you, our Lord.
You,
hallelujah be unto your name.
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Once again, I want to welcome each and every one of us to the presence of the Lord. And I'm so glad for what God is doing in our lives. Either we like it or not, one thing I want to point out to you and to make it clear to you. The plan and the purpose of God for our lives cannot be aborted. The only thing the enemy can do, they can delay it. But at the appointed time, to surely come to pass. At the appointed time, Lord will not tarry. It will come to pass. I prophesy and I pray. As the shame has gone away from your life, will never return to you again.
Amen.
In the name of Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Happiness will be your portion.
Amen.
Goodness will be your portion.
Amen.
And Lord will bless you bountifully.
Amen.
Wherever you get to, you will be a blessing to people.
Amen.
Blessing to yourself.
Amen.
Blessing to your generation.
Amen.
So shall it be.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
By the grace of God, I want to thank God again for giving me the ability and the opportunity to come and deliver this message. This message I've received a couple of weeks ago, but I was looking for a way how God wants you to galvanize them together and package them, you know, in the two that, you know, people will be able to get it by the special grace of God. I don't want to come and deliver it by my flesh. But thank God for the grace that God has given me and the place He has given me in heaven to occupy at this time. To come and share the word with our people. Praise ye the Lord.
Hallelujah.
By the grace of God, I'll be talking on the topic that talks about becoming a listening generation.
Hallelujah.
Becoming a listening generation. We read from the book of Samuel, and we heard the way God spoke to Samuel at a tender age. In the olden days, the Bible says the word of the Lord was so scarce, and the word of the Lord bypassed the kings, bypassed the nobles and princesses, all of them went to the wilderness to go and meet John the Baptist. I pray today as I preach this word that the word of the Lord will locate you wherever you are. I said the word of the Lord will locate you wherever you are. And we move and run with the word of the Lord. In the name of the Lord Jesus. In becoming a listening generation. The word listening, what it is? To make an effort to hear something. To pay attention to something. You want to listen to something. You want to hear something. But the question is, what are you listening to? What are you hearing? I pray we hear the word of the Lord today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
The psalmist says, your word I keep it in my heart for me not to sin against you. Hallelujah. The first prayer of Samuel is speak, for your servant is hearing. That's the first prayer. When you begin to speak, it started with speak, for your servant is here. See, I'm will quickly catalog for you, you know, the scenario that happened in those days. Eli was a kind of a priest that's so high in the priestly order. And he has sons, two sons, Hophni and Phinehas. But guess what? They have defied the plan of God in the land. They have messed up. And God was busy looking for somebody he can talk to again. See, when you begin to wallow in sin, you begin to lie, you begin to do all sorts of things that does not edify. God will not be able to speak to you. You will not be able to hear the word of the Lord because you have deviated. You are no more in partnership with God. But our partnership with God shall not be soiled in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
But because from time to time, we need to be able to hear from God. So he couldn't hear the word of God again. The whole land were in disobey. They were running Esther's favor. Things are not going on well. Until God said, I am looking for a listening generation. A generation that will be able to listen to me. We are in a generation that we are moving from one end to another, hustling, bustling, crisscrossing the acts of the whole world to better our lives. The Bible says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. All other things shall be added unto thee. Hallelujah.
Amen.
At a point, Samuel became a listening generation at the level that God can unveil his mind to him. As a child of God, if you are not operating at this level, by which God can uncover his mind to you about your life, about your family, about a community, about a nation, about a church like this, you will become a man most miserable. Because you begin to do things out of flesh. If you have not heard from God, if God has not spoken to you, what is the mind of God? In those days, we called them seers. I saw them on the internet, that school of the seers. I think somebody sent it to me, I don't know. I just saw it on the internet. School of the seers. People that see, you know, into your future. They use tarot, teshbal, leaf, black leaf, you know, and with a kind of spiritual gyration to know into your future, to predict. And I say, whoa! Because I'm the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. If you look into their life is tantamount to poverty, arrogance, and stuff like that. They could not even better themselves. The God that have eyes that they cannot see, ears cannot hear, a mouth that cannot speak. Unfortunately, the generation we are in is a speaking generation. We love to speak every time. We come before the Lord to present our related matters every time. No ability to wait before the Lord to listen. Even while you are praying, your phone is ringing. Your mind is there to jump out from prayer room to go and answer your call and make a call back. We are not listening anymore. We are in a generation that will do pop out. We don't want to receive back from God. But the Lord is speaking here that want to raise somebody here, you know, to become a listening people. A listening pastor, a listening chronister. listening new generation, I'll be able to listen to what God is saying about your family. You are head of family. You don't know the mind of God even for your children, for your family. You are a pastor. You don't have even focus for your sheep. As a shepherd, you are the director or managing director of a company. You don't have no directives from God. You don't know what God is saying about how to move even your company forward. We do have the ability to come to God and speak to Him for hours, but to not be able to listen to what He's saying even for 1 minute. Not be able to listen to what God wants to tell us. Before I come to that, Samuel, the book of Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 1 to 3 is a loaded scripture whereby God is saying that. Saying to Habakkuk, chapter 2, Habakkuk said, I will stand my watch and set myself on the rampart. I watch to see what he will say to me and what I will answer when I am corrected. See, we take instruction from our parents before we do anything. When we are still younger. Because we are not mature yet. Even up to now, you take counsel from your parents. People that have parents, I cherish you. Because you take counsel from them from time to time. But why is it that God has made you? You do not take counsel from Him. You jump out to do whatever you like. He said, then the Lord answered and said to me, write the vision. Which vision are you writing? Do you have any vision from God? What do you have from God? A listening generation. Habakkuk has listened. He has seen what God wants to do. Say, write a vision and make it play upon the tablet that he may run that read it. He said, for the vision is for an appointed time, but at the end it will sleep and will not lie. Though it tarries, wait for it, because it shall surely come to pass. It is a season of harvest, and God wants to harvest soul to his kingdom. God wants to harness from you his ability, wants to harness from you, you know, all the ingredients that he has imprinted in you. But have you listened to God? That God, how, where, and in what order? I will answer you the order it was received, right? You are not there for God to speak to you, and God is busy looking for us. You are here to move from one job to another, which is fine. You are there to move even from one end to another, which is fine. You are there, you know, to service people, activities, stuff, which is good. But guess what? Without the work of the Lord, without the word from God, that hustling and bustling may amount to nothing. But I pray that the Lord will open your ears today to hear the word of the Lord. The Lord will open your ears today to hear what God wants to speak. He said, what eyes have not seen, what ear have not heard, I will do. He spoke to Joshua. He said, things that I will do that when people hear it, their ear will what? Tingle. Have you at any point in time even be on your brain to know what is the purpose of God for my husband? What is the purpose of God for my spouse, for my children? Do you have word for them? Do you have word for a generation or a country like this? No word anymore. We use our human knowledge, which is failing us. I pray that Lord will break us down.
Amen.
To humble ourselves.
Amen.
For God to be able to speak to us.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you speak and you do not listen to the feedback and take instruction from your master, you will be going astray or get lost. The sheep will be wandering and shouting about because he has lost control of his master. When master was speaking to him, he couldn't listen. I pray you not get lost in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say I pray you not get lost in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
It's so sad in my heart sometimes when you see some prophet, man of God, they will say God has spoken when God has not told them anything. They will say, thus says the Lord. They will say, next year, you know, there's going to be triple blessing. God says, I'm going to bless you triply. And next year, you are still in debt. Kind of cliche principle. You've not heard from God. You've not heard from God. You want people to know that if you give me prayer points, if I pray 365 and God is not speaking anything, I'm not going to tell that God has spoken anything. Because he says, if you add to my word, I'm going to add to your plague. If you remove from my word, our name shall not be removed from the book of life. Becoming a listening generation. God is busy looking for a listening generation. One major ingredient in becoming a listening generation is your foundation. Where is your foundation? The Bible says in the book of Psalm 11 verse 3 that if the foundation is destroyed, what can the righteous do? Or the foundation are destroyed. What can the righteous do? You know, will do nothing because your foundation speaking against you. We come into a generation whereby God will be able to depend upon us to give us his mind, to give us his heartbeat, to give us what he tends to do at this time. Because people are in a hurry, you want to make it, you will see teenagers, they want to ride on Lamborghini. You will see people, they want to build massive edifice. They want to build, you know, they want to build empire to themselves. You want to want them to call their building estate. He build estate. Some of you will go to internet. What does he want? He do not know what he wants. What do you want to do about it? But what do you want in the Lord? Hallelujah. Becoming a listening generation. Can somebody say that? Becoming a listening generation. So one of the ingredients to become a listening generation is your foundation. Samuel had the foundation of Samuel helped him to always stay in the presence of God. That's number one ingredient, your foundation. And I've told you how his foundation, you know, helped him. Number two ingredient is stay in the presence of God. You will not be able to listen to God if you are not in his presence. If you are in a chaotic mood, if you are at loggerhead with somebody every time, argument every time. One of my executive directors will say, you know, every time we bring in, we don't want to solve problems. Yes! So don't be a point of contact to solving problems that God will deliver you. Amen. To become a listening generation, to be able to listen to God, to stay in his presence. Where are you staying right now? Even where you are living, the cloud may be so thick that the word of the Lord cannot penetrate. That you will not be able to hear the word of the Lord anytime. You cannot see the vision of God. The vision you are seeing is masquerade pursuing you. Python want to bite you. Python want to snatch you. Or you say, Pastor, Python or Simon came yesterday, he bit me. No. Becoming a listening generation. The foundation of Samuel, let's see from that first Samuel, chapter 1, verse 5. Hear this. There was a man called Elkanah. You know Elkanah? Elkanah has how many wives? Two wives. He has Hannah and Peninnah. Peninnah was favored with children, but Hannah was barren. Was she barren? Was Hannah barren? Was Hannah barren? God bless you, sir. God bless you. Bible scholar will tell you no. Hannah did not bury. Number 5, verse 5. But to Hannah, he will give a double portion. That's Elkanah. I'm talking about Elkanah here now. For he loved Hannah, though the Lord has closed her womb. So to show you that Hannah was sheep barren, God shut her womb for a purpose. That thing you are going through is for a purpose. Have you discovered that? God, the Bible said, my thought towards you is not of evil. If I've come to America the time I wanted to come, forget about it. But at the appointed time that God said, okay, the time has come, he opened the door and God is moving forward. That time you want to get that job, God said no, but the job that God is giving you is with emolument. Hallelujah. The time that God is giving you that children is going to be children that will be a blessing to their generation. And guess what? Every problem has an expiry date. As every problem has an expiry date. But inability to wait for your expiry date makes you to jump gone. Not to be able to wait on God. I prophesy and I pray from here, from this altar. Every of that your problem will expire this year in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God shut her womb. But when God shut her womb, she was not, you know, attached to one woman, to one pastor, to one somebody, it's because of you. Because God shut her womb. And do you know what happened to Hannah? Hannah knew. Then, when Ophni and Phinehas, the children of Eli, has failed in their priestly office, and God was busy looking for a generation that would be able to listen to him, God now went to Hannah. Hannah that did not have connection with Eli. He shot Aaron. See, I want to submit to you. If Hannah refused to understand that God shot Aaron for a purpose, he will remain barren forever. Let me use that word. You know, the womb will be closed forever. But she knew that God shut her womb for a purpose. That problem is for a purpose. It's going to be a blessing in disguise for you in Jesus' name. Because shame will be rolled away from you. He said, this day I've rolled away the reproach of Egypt from you. It will never come back. In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Amen.
And they said, and her rival also provoked her severally to make her miserable because the Lord had closed her womb. Let me now come to verse 11. And 11 to 15 says, then she made a vow unto the Lord. Someone that has closed your womb, you still make vow even to him. He said, oh Lord, verse 11. If you will indeed look on the affliction of your maidservant and remember me and not forget your maidservant, but will give your maidservant a male child that I will give him to the Lord all the days of his life, and no resort shall come upon his head. Look at the foundation that this man has laid already for Samuel. Do you know the kind of foundation he laid for you when he wanted to give back to you? I remember his stories told that man was a drunkard. And the wife would never pray to redeem this man. And one day this man was coming in the middle of the night, drunken and stuff like that, you know. Came there and the wife was sleeping carelessly. Oh, this man, why? Bam! By the time you know it, they gave back to his boys. Those twins, they drink like anything. Well, that is their foundation. I pray such will not be your foundation in Jesus' name.
Amen.
But look at the foundation here. Before this woman even met her husband, he already laid foundation. That if God, you can give me a nature, that this one will not touch his head. Every faulty and erroneous foundation in your life that came from your ancestor, that's making you to behave erratically, and what we call it to collapse in Jesus' name.
Yeah.
And Lord will give you a new foundation, which is Christ Jesus.
Yeah.
Foundation is so powerful in the life of you. And God said, you are able to plug into my mind. And I am busy looking, ringing bell from heaven, busy looking for some a nature that will be able to listen to me. Since you have done this, you got yourself connected. Yes, and God. Verse 12 says, and it happened as she continued praying before the Eli watched her mouth. Now Anna spoke in her heart, only her lips moved, by her voice, but her voice was not heard at all. It wasn't a loud prayer. At that time, he did not. When I ask you to increase the volume of your prayer, not a loud prayer that people will see, but within yourself, you increase the volume of your prayer within yourself. Verse 15, but Anna answered and said, no, okay. Then Eli thought she was drunk. So Eli said to her, how long will you be drunk? But your wine, put your wine away from you. Said, but Anna answered and said, no, my Lord. I am a woman of sorrowful spirit. I have drunk neither wine nor intoxicating drink, but have poured out my soul before the Lord. Where do you pour your soul? Mm. You pour your soul to your employer. You can die at your job. You can walk. I know it's against federal law here to walk beyond 16 hours. But people will still do this. They say, I'm not going to clock. But my son, I said, no. You can walk around the clock. But his soul, our soul was unto the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Chapter 2, verse 15 now. No, verse 16. Say, do not consider your maidservant a wicked woman. For out of the abundance of my complaints and grief, I have spoken of thee now. So, Hannah did what he's supposed to do before the Lord. He laid a good foundation and he made a vow of things we have not gotten. Some people will say my resolution in the year, all of my tithe will be coming to God. If you give me this job, give me this job, give me this job, they will pray all manner of prayers. After getting the job, pastor will be telling them, pastor, you know, it's so tight. It will not be tight for you in Jesus' name. It will be easy for you in the name of Lord Jesus. Something motivated, you know, or hand to raise a listening generation. So I call it motivating factor. Assurance of God's plan for your life. Assurance of God's plan for your life is a motivating factor. But do you even know the assurance of God for your life? Have you ever shut down 365 days? The 365 days, you are always on the move. Always overtime, always crisis, always everything. No time to shut down. Shut down before the Lord. Forget about the food, forget about the activities. You want to come before the Lord. Come to the presence of the Lord to see what God will speak to you. Deuteronomy chapter 8. I want to show you something there. Verses 7. Deuteronomy chapter 8 from verses 7. For the Lord your God is bringing you into a good land. A land of brooks of water, of fountain and spring that flow out of valley and hills. A land of wheat and barley, of vine and fig trees and pomegranate, a land of olive oil and honey, a land in which you will eat bread without scarcity. Mm-hmm. This is the assurance of the land that God is taking children of Israel to. He showed it to who? To Moses. Moses passed across to Joshua. So they knew where they were going. Where are you going? What have you received from God? Have God spoken to you? How the journey is going to be? So the assurance of God's plan is a motivating factor to become a listening generation. If you are sure of what God is speaking about, then you'll be able to listen very well. Assurance of God's plan makes you to overcome all the obstacles in your way. Obstacles will come. Valleys will come. But you have a sure word of God from Him that you will overcome. And that one will be a motivating factor to be able to overcome all the mountain coming before you. He said, who are now great mountain before Zerubbabel? She shall become plain. Hallelujah. If you must prosper, you must understand how to discern the voice of God. That's another thing. If you must prosper